Something really honest and simple about the classic Fender Telecaster. This is not a Telecaster by definition. This is a broadcaster. This is a 70th anniversary broadcaster released this year for 2020. It's in a lovely clear butterscotch nitro finish. It's an ash body, two pieces of ash. There's a really almost, you can hardly see it, indiscernible seam running down here. If you have a look at the back, you'll see that beautiful grain come through. One piece maple neck, good chunky man size neck. Seven and a quarter inch radius, vintage radius. But the frets are a little bit bigger than vintage, so there's something, you know, substantial to grab onto. These pickups are custom shop hand-wound 50-51 pickups of the day, you know, back in 1950-1951, they've got plenty of twang. The classic bridge with the serial number stamped into it. The brass classic Telecaster or broadcaster saddles, you know, with no special intonation compensation or anything like that. It's a pretty simple affair, but they sound great. Phenolic pick guard, all of the screws are flathead screws because the Phillips head wasn't introduced until late 51, if I'm not mistaken. So it's just got so much charm and so much simplicity. I'm just running into a classic deluxe reverb, 65 deluxe reverb. Emulation on the mighty XFX 3, my best friend in the studio. And there's just so much joy out of playing something so beautiful, I think, and simple. So that's the bridge pickup. Here's the two of them. Up. Know what I'm saying? Put a bit of delay and reverb in just to give yourself, you know, a little bit of room. Played Telecasters a long, long time, since the 70s. When this design was only, you know, 25 years old. So I'm quite familiar with them, and that's probably why they feel so comfortable to me. Even the Ernie Ball guitars that I like to play a lot, the Albert Lee is based on the Telecaster, Stratocaster kind of clone, but there's nothing like the real thing, I've got to say. It's just... Thank you. it's just such a joy. Skunk stripe, of course, through here we've got the truss rod. The truss rod is adjustable in the old fashioned way. The first ones were no casters; they didn't have a truss rod, but they pretty soon found out that they need one because of the temperature changes across the US. So you can get under there for the truss rod, but the neck is you know, it's because it's one piece. We've already had some severe temperature changes here in Australia, and I haven't had to adjust it all or even consider adjusting it once, which is a cool thing. In fact, it was in steamy Brisbane only a couple of days ago, and it's you would never know. Machine heads are Clouson, classic Clouson types. Classic Clousons. Yeah, so throw a drive in front, here's an AC boost. Through a rotary device, I know I'm showing off the effects a little bit here, but these guitars lend themselves so much to this kind of thing. Where's that drive again? Yeah, it weighs not very much at all, 3.5 kilos, which is, you know, on the lighter side, I think, perfect weight really, especially considering it's a big chunk of ash and a big chunk of maple. They're just gorgeous things. So look, if you're looking for something that's authentic and not custom shop pricing, but is built really well, this one's staying with me. I've already gigged it once, and it'll be doing a lot more, along with the Esquire, which I'm also fortunate to have. The 70th anniversary Fender Broadcaster. Gorgeous thing. See ya. Mm-hmm.